My name is Saba Ahmed. I was an MPhil student at Jamia before joining the Urban Fellows program. I've completed my master's in development studies, bachelor's in political science, and yeah, so now I'm here. One of my classmates from master's was in the first UFP batch, and I had another friend in the first UFP batch. So it was because of them that I got to know about the program. So Sonal had actually told me, listen, I can't describe the program to you because it'll be a cakewalk at times, and it'll be like a train wreck at times. It's so intensive, you won't figure out when it gets over. And I just thought she was being crazy. So I kind of took her word for it. And then I spoke to a few other people. Gautam's work I'd been following for a long time. So I thought probably this is good enough to give it was a leap of faith, to be very honest. I think if I had to summarize what the fellowship was about, I'd say that I have done like a sufficient amount of time in conventional degrees, 7 years to be precise, more than seven years in conventional university like curriculum systems with theoretical degrees. I didn't find the kind of application and use of skills that the university system should have ideally given me, and which is what I was looking for. I think UFP gives you the knowledge and it throws you into real life scenarios where you use your own theoretical knowledge to enhance your arguments, to make a point, to figure out where things are going wrong. I think that is very important. The UFP curriculum in itself was very exciting because it's unconventional, it's flexible. It teaches you a bit of everything and it tells you how you've got to make your arguments better, not by just relying on, say, somebody else's theory or, you know, data given to you by some ministry, or it helps you make a coherent, coercive argument. And I think that is really important. You put to make a point, and in general, we're always taught about rural studies. There's very little focus even in university systems on urban studies because it's assumed the urban has lesser problems as compared to the rural. I think this program changes a lot of those misconceptions. So, yeah. I think I really enjoyed studying the commons because everything that we picked up, be it inequality, governance or economy, even in fact ecology and infrastructure, the ones that I was not acquainted with at all, you studied things from a specific angle because the lecturer wanted you to look at it that way. But it was important because those things were like nuances that you wouldn't notice yourself unless somebody had trained you to. So I really enjoyed the way the commons was taught and how it went about describing things, like not just their the condition at the local level or a regional level, but in general, how do you look at something and figure out where the problem lies? Our classroom has more of architects, not as many as the previous batch had, but in general, there were a lot of architects. And I do not have any sense of creative visualization or like in general, I do not understand how do you engage audiences in a non-academic sort of a forum. Like for example, I didn't even know how to make a mind map digitally. There was somebody in class who told me you could make a mind map digitally using this software. And for me, that itself was revolutionary because nobody told me I could do that. And I frankly didn't know that there were for my master's dissertation, I drew each map by hand. So, I mean, the thing that the part where, Teja came to class and he was like, okay, this you can do with a map. This is how Google Earth works. This is how everything will happen. And I was like, somebody should have taught me this earlier because I spent like 3 months trying to draw each map. So I mean, when it comes to my classmates, it was nice to have people with different trainings because then, like in a class of social scientists, everybody will say capitalism is bad. But in a class of lawyers and architects and designers, everybody's, you know, somebody will come up and say, oh, this was bad from the legal perspective. This was bad because it was not implemented well. This was bad because it was designed incorrectly. This was bad because the target population was wrong. And then you look at the same policy, the same program, and then you realize that there are problems at different levels and not just, you know, on the final sheet that you get. I think this fellowship, for me, it has been very eye-opening because I was planning to do a PhD in the development sector. But and my PhD proposal was on housing for refugees. So I went in for a PhD interview and I presented my proposal, which is on housing for refugees in India. And somebody asked me, have you ever seen a housing complex or a settlement made for refugees? And I had not. And then I realized there was something really wrong with where I was going and the way I was being trained. So that was one of my wake-up points, and I realized that I need to figure out how to go back and connect with ground reality, see applications of things. And that is why I think UFP holds a lot of relevance. I think urban practices, it's not just urban practice, it's also about how do you engage with theory, how do you accept ground reality the way it is, how do you design solutions, and how do you mitigate something. So that way, I think the entire program in terms of the practice, because you need theory as well as practice, it has to be an interconnection of both. So I think that is why this really holds like a great amount of relevance. It doesn't matter if I continue with my same PhD proposal or if I pick up a new one. I think it's important that UFP has trained me that I can look at a variety of things and not be limited by the theory or not be limited by the set practice. I design my own methods, which is exactly what Gautam teaches. He teaches mixed methodology in research. And I think you figure out your own path after this, not just in terms of a policy or a sector, but in your way of thinking. I think that is really important. Once you know how to ask the right questions, you can figure out what you're going to do. But if you've not figured that out, then you really need a UFP. I think for the UFP, the highlight for me will be the interconnected curriculum, the way it is, also how different it is from what is conventionally taught. No university as of now, even though I went to a very liberal and a very, very swanky one, but nobody teaches you how to put a GIS and say something like inequality together. I think if you have anyhow, the social scientists, they're being replaced by engineers anyhow. If you have something that puts the two skills together and trains you to think in a better manner. So I think, for those people, UFP makes more sense. So project that I'm doing right now is on the urban land economies. It is a study of Jolly Mohalla in Bangalore. And we are looking at how land plays an important role in businesses. What keeps the small businesses there? It's an informal urban economy. How do the rentals work? What keeps people in the same place that they've been for the past 50, 60 years, considering there have been changes in the economy at the national level, say demonetization or GST or the plastic ban? What keeps scrap waste dealers in that same place, which is in the center of the city? And yeah, that's mostly about it. I don't know, it's like there's so much, and I can't believe the 7 months are over. It just went by too fast. I really don't know how to summarize it or put an end to it. It's been so frustrating at times because, you have deadlines and you're trying to do 4 things at a time, and, you know, it gets really difficult to manage. But then I think I'll miss being this busy. I think if somebody were to ask me what UFP is like or why one should do a UFP, I tell them the same thing that was told to me, that it's an intensive program, it consumes most of you, but it's going to be the most enjoyable 7 months of your mundane academic life, or if you're trying to figure out what master's degree you were supposed to do, or what where does your practice or where does your theoretical background take you further. I think for those people, it's a very good way to engage with the social, not just the practice but the theory, and figure out what you're trying to do.